fast. You guys are ready to hear Maude. Hi, welcome to University of Portland. My name is Laurie Kelley, and I serve here as the Chief Marketing Officer, and it's just great to see all of you out here tonight. We're really happy to have you here. Before we get started this evening, I would like to take this opportunity to really thank the host of this event. And along with the University of Portland, your hosts are Food and Water Watch and the Oregon Environmental Council. And also, if you've participated in some of the sessions today as well, we have sponsors involved with the event, and those are the Confederated Tribes of the Grand Ronde, Bon Appetit, Portland Spirit, the Bullet Foundation, Doubletree Hotel, Illahi, the Port of Portland, Vigor Industrial, Environmental Services of the City of Portland, Kinder Morgan, Portland Water Bureau, and OPB. We thank you all. Also, I really want to publicly acknowledge a couple people here at University of Portland that have really made this come to pass here, and that is Father Tom Doyle, who really conceived of this whole notion of bringing a big event circulating around water to University of Portland, Dr. Steve Combs, who has worked tirelessly to make this event happen, along with Amy Leischer and Dwayne Fullerton. They're really the engines who brought this weekend together, and I want to give them a round of applause. And now I'd like to introduce Nancy Matela from Food and Water Watch. Nancy.
Thanks, Lori. It's trite, but I'm going to say it anyway. Our keynote speaker is one of my personal heroes, and I was just thrilled when she said yes to our invitation. I got a second thrill, however, when the person said yes who's going to be introducing our keynote speaker. He's rapidly getting on my list of personal heroes. That would be John Kroger, the Oregon Attorney General. John has devoted his entire life to public service, first as a United States Marine, then a federal prosecutor, a public policy expert, and a professor of law. John was elected in November 2008 after winning the nominations of both the Democratic and the Republican Party for the state of Oregon. The next thing was quite amazing. I had not known this about him. He won every county in the state of Oregon, accruing more Oregon votes than any other candidate on the ballot, including President Barack Obama. Pretty amazing. Talk about bipartisan across the aisle. And it goes on. He's going to blush before he gets up here, but that's my job. As a federal criminal prosecutor, John won major cases against mafia killers, drug kingpins, and corrupt government officials. He helped prosecute the crooked Enron executives and served on the emergency response team to the 9/11 terrorist attack on the World Trade Center. In recognition of his work, he got commendations from the FBI, the Drug Enforcement Administration, and the State Department. In 1999, he also received the highest award from the Attorney General's office at that time, it was Janet Reno, for convicting two mafia captains for committing multiple murders. John wrote about his experiences as a prosecutor in his book called Conviction, so hopefully those sales will spike tonight at Powell's or Amazon, and it won the 2009 Oregon Book Award. Before that, he received his master's and bachelor's degrees in philosophy from Yale University and his law degree with honors from Harvard Law School. Prior to his election as Attorney General, he served as a law professor at Portland's Lewis and Clark Law School. From the Willamette to the Malheur Rivers in Oregon, every major river currently fails federal and state water quality standards for at least one pollutant. That's current, every major river. And that's why he set up in the last year the Environmental Crimes Enforcement Unit at the Oregon Department of Justice. Now, this unit is after air polluters, earth polluters, and water polluters, but we'll only talk about water tonight. This unit immediately levels the playing field. For those companies who play by the rules, they will no longer be penalized when the other folks do the shortcuts. This will send, or is sending, currently a strong and unequivocal message to companies that violate the law. If they purposefully, repeatedly, and illegally threaten the environment and damage public health, they will be held accountable. And John tells me that there are several cases right now that they are pursuing. And if you dare test his resolve, just remember what happened to the mafia bosses, the crooked Enron officials, and maybe even some Lewis and Clark law students. May I present Attorney General John Kroger?